Deep under the lush tropical tree crowns of Flores Island, Indonesia, for centuries a mystery has quietly stood waiting for us. A mystery that would challenge our understanding of human evolution and spark a scientific debate that continues to this day. Welcome to the world of hobbits, Homo Floresiensis, a species of small people whose existence we find out only in 2003 and turned anthropology upside down. In the heart of this remote island, a discovery has been made that is sending shockwaves through the scientific community. In the depths of Liang Bua Cave, the skeleton remains of a creature unlike any other were discovered. Standing just over a meter tall, with brains the size of a chimpanzee, these creatures were undoubtedly human, but strikingly different from us. These are the hobbits of Flores Island, a species that lived and thrived alongside our ancestors but remained hidden from us until the dawn of the 21st century. But who were these hobbits? How did they come to inhabit this isolated island, and what led to their mysterious disappearance? Did Homo Floresiensis and our species Homo sapiens ever come into contact with each other? The answers to these and other interesting questions are coming in the next few minutes. The journey of Homo Floresiensis to their isolated home of Flores Island is a story shrouded in mystery. Hypotheses abound, but their exact route and manner of arrival remain elusive, a mystery that has yet to be fully solved. One of the prevailing theories suggests that the ancestors of the hobbits arrived on the island more than a million years ago. They may have been swept out to sea during a tsunami or storm, clinging to plant rafts to survive. After landing on the shores of Flores, they found themselves in a new world, a secluded island teeming with life. The hobbits adapted to their new home, evolving over hundreds of thousands of years into the unique form we know today as Homo Floresiensis. Their small stature may have been an adaptation to the island's limited resources, a phenomenon known as island dwarfism. Over time, they became part of the diverse ecosystem of the island. Their physical characteristics, including large teeth for their small size, forward shoulders, and relatively large feet due to their short legs, seem them apart from all known human species. Despite their small brain size, they displayed an intelligence that belied their physical size. They made and used stone tools, hunted small elephants and large rodents, and probably even used fire. Yet this is only a small part of the puzzle. The story of the arrival of the hobbits on the island of Flores is intertwined with a large narrative of human evolution, a narrative that is consistently evolving with new discoveries. By exploring the world of the ancient hobbits, we not only uncover their past, but also sort out our own evolutionary journey. Homo Floresiensis intrigued scientists from the moment they learned about them. With their unique brain size and intelligence, despite their small stature of just 3.5 feet, these ancient hominins had brains that were larger than originally thought. Although small in absolute size when considering their body size, the brain of Homo Floresiensis actually matched that of modern humans. This suggests that despite their small stature, hobbits were likely capable of complex cognitive tasks. The structure of their brain is studied by scanning the skull. Results indicate advanced cognitive processing, including potential for language capabilities, tool use, and social interaction. However, the small size of the gray matter of the hobbits causes fierce debate among scientists. Some argue that it is this, combined with their isolated environment, that may have led to a form of island dwarfism. Others suggest that the hobbits may have had a condition known as microcephaly, a neurological disorder that results in smaller than normal head size. Despite all this, the evidence is indisputable. Hobbits were a distinct species with the brain size and intelligence that suited their environment and lifestyle. Their story is a testament to their incredible diversity and adaptability of the human race, a path of evolution that we are only now beginning to understand. This race of small people were expert toolmakers. They made sophisticated stone tools that were used for hunting and possibly for other purposes. This implies a level of cognitive complexity, usually associated with the ability to master a language. Furthermore, the social organization necessary for cooperative hunting in which they are thought to have engaged also suggests the use of some form of communication. However, without direct evidence such as symbolic artifacts or written records, it is difficult to say for sure whether they had a language. The culture of the Hobbits is also no less interesting. They lived in a challenging environment, surrounded by fearsome predators, such as Komodo dragons. Despite everything, they managed to survive and develop, probably with the help of fire and the construction of simple shelters. This suggests a level of culture adaptation that is remarkable for a species with such a small brain size. The story of the Hobbits of Flores Island takes on an even more intriguing character when we consider their potential interactions with modern humans. Despite their small stature and unique evolutionary path, these ancient hominins may have encountered our own species, Homo sapiens. Hobbits lived on the island of Flores until around 50,000 years ago, a time when modern humans were already inhabiting the world. This raises the existing possibility that the two species may have met. However, the evidence for such a meeting is circumstantial at best. The Hobbits disappeared around the same time that modern humans are thought to have arrived in the region, but no direct evidence of contact or conflict has been found. Nevertheless, the possibility of such an encounter has profound implications for our understanding of human evolution. It suggests that our species shared the planet with other hominins much longer than previously thought. It also raises questions about the fate of the Hobbits. Did they become extinct naturally? Or was this event preempted by modern humans? These are questions that continue to challenge researchers today. The story of the Hobbits and their potential interaction with modern humans underscores the fact that we are not the end product of a linear progression, but rather one branch of a rich and diverse evolutionary tree. The mystery of the extinction of Homo floresiensis is a fascinating chapter in the annals of human evolution. Theories about the reason for their disappearance are numerous. Some suggest that modern humans had a hand in this. Others believe that the environmental changes on the islands of Flores, such as volcanic eruption or climate change, led to their demise. One of the most compelling hypotheses is that of island dwarfism, a phenomenon in which species evolve smaller body sizes in response to the limited resources available on the islands. This may have resulted in the species becoming increasingly vulnerable to environmental changes and ultimately led to its extinction. Fossils found are scarce, and the existence evidence can be interpreted in a variety of ways. In the realm of ancient DNA, Homo floresiensis is an incredible enigma. The genetic material of these miniature humanoids is elusive. Despite numerous attempts, scientists have not yet been able to extract and sequence DNA from the remains of these ancient creatures. This is largely due to the island's tropical climate, which is not conducive to preserving DNA for a long period of time. The lack of genetic data has left a huge hole in our understanding of these creatures. Without DNA evidence, we can only speculate about their evolutionary origins, their relationship to other humanoid species, and the genetic characteristics that may have contributed to their unique physical characteristics. However, the search for a Hobbit DNA is far from over. Scientists continue to perfect their techniques for extracting and sequencing ancient DNA, and there is hope that the future technological advances may finally allow us to unlock the genetic secrets of the species. If this proves successful, it could revolutionize our understanding of human evolution and rewrite the history of our ancient past. The comparison between Homo floresiensis and African pygmies is interesting because it reveals the diverse palette of human evolution. While both groups are characterized by short stature, the similarities largely end there, highlighting the unique evolutionary path each has taken. Unlike the mysterious hobbits from the island of Flores, who lived in Southeast Asia until about 50,000 years ago, African pygmies are modern humans who inhabited the equatorial rainforest of Central Africa. Their short stature, with adult males usually not exceeding 150 centimeters, 4 feet 11 inches in height, is believed to be an adaptation to the dense forest environment that allowed them to move more easily and maintain their physical heat more effectively. Unlike Homo floresiensis, African pygmies are not a separate species, but rather a group of ethnicities within Homo sapiens and have the same cognitive abilities as other modern humans. The differences between these two groups highlight the remarkable adaptability of the human lineage. Despite their similar stature, Homo floresiensis and African pygmies represent two very different responses to environmental pressures, shaped by the unique circumstances of their respective habitats. This comparison shows the complexity of human evolution and the myriad paths it can take. In human evolution, three strands clearly stand out: Homo naledi, Homo habilis, and Homo floresiensis. With their unique characteristics, they raise countless questions about our lineage. Homo naledi, found in the Rising Star Cave system in South Africa, is a paradox of primitive and advanced traits. With a brain about a third the size of modern humans, curved fingers adapted for climbing, but equipped with human-like legs and hands capable of using tools, Homo naledi is a fascinating mix of archaic and modern. The mystery depends whether revolutions about their behavior involving burial rituals, a trait previously thought to be unique to Homo sapiens. Homo habilis, aptly named Dexterous Man, is believed to be the earliest representative of the genus Homo. Discovered in Olduvai Gorge, Tanzania, Homo habilis displays a mixture of ape-like and human-like features, with a larger brain than its Australopithecus predecessors and smaller teeth. Homo habilis also provides evidence of tool use, making a significant step in human evolution. However, its exact place in our genealogy remains a matter of debate. Homo floresiensis, the hobbit of Flores Island, is perhaps the most enigmatic of the three species. Standing just over a meter tall, with a brain comparable to that of a chimpanzee, but with the advanced traits such as tool use and possibly even fire, Homo floresiensis challenges our understanding of what it means to be human. The mystery of whether they evolved from a population of Homo erectus that became isolated and underwent island dwarfism, or whether they represent an entirely separate line of hominins, despite all the evidence, remains a matter of mystery and fierce debate. If you like what we do, support us by subscribing to the channel and leaving a comment.